Mila from Inside Education. Today I'm going to show you how easy it is to catch aquatic invertebrates just using tools from home. Before we get started though, we should probably figure out what the word invertebrate even means. So can I get everyone who's watching to reach around your back and feel your spine? As humans, we have a spine or a backbone, which means that we are vertebrates. Invertebrates, on the other hand, do not have a spine or a backbone. Instead, they often have what's called an exoskeleton, which is like armor that surrounds their body. So I'm going to use this net, which is really just a strainer from home, and see if I can catch some aquatic invertebrates that might be overwintering in this wetland here. Which I'm going to add to our collection of other aquatic invertebrates that we've already caught today. Now, I isolated some of these aquatic invertebrates into an ice cube tray over here. This one right here is called a side swimmer. It has a hard exoskeleton and it swims on its side. This one here is called a water boatman. A water boatman looks very similar to a back swimmer. This last one I'll show you right away is called a mayfly nymph. We can tell because it has three very thin tails. A lot of invertebrates that we have in Alberta actually start their life and spend a good portion of their life cycle underwater. That mayfly nymph, for example, it can overwinter underwater, like the one that we just caught is doing, and then in May or June, it'll grow wings and emerge into the sky as an adult mayfly. So, this wetland that I'm standing in front of is a pond. And the wetland in front of me is called a fen. Wetlands are important for a number of different reasons. They're important because they provide important habitat for plants and animals. They filter chemicals and sediments to leave the water clean. And they actually act as a carbon sink. That means that they absorb harmful greenhouse gases from the atmosphere and hold them for a very, very long time. Now, I just told you two of the types of wetlands we have in Alberta. I told you about the pond and the fen, but we actually have five types of wetlands here in Alberta. Can you figure out what the three other types of wetlands are called? Thank you so much for watching, and I hope this video has inspired you to take some tools from home, find a nearby wetland, and catch some aquatic invertebrates.